Hello, I'm Ellie for Edu for Java. This is tutorial number 7 of Android game programming. In this tutorial, we're going to see touch events and sprite collision detection. What am I talking about? In the last tutorial, we had managed to do all this: sprites moving in different speeds from one place to another. Now we want that when we click on one of them, it should disappear. For example, I click, and they should disappear. How are we going to do this? The first thing we're going to do is to override a method of the view. In the game view, Surface view has a method which we can override. This one here. On touch event. Okay, Shift Control F to order. Shift Control O for the imports. This event is going to be called each time we put our fingers on the screen. And we're going to receive an event which has two properties, get x and get y, which is going to give us the position of the mouse where the finger pressed the screen. In the emulator, it is going to be a click. From now on, I'm going to speak of onTouch event and click event as the same thing. Let's iterate on each of the sprites and see for each of the sprites if there is a collision or not. A collision would be if the coordinates x, y, where I did click and the area occupied by the sprite are the same. I'm going to do this through a method called is collision, which I have to develop now and in which I am going to send as parameters the coordinates x and y of where it touches. What I'm going to do is sprites.remove of the collection of sprites, and I'm going to do a remove of the sprite which collides. This one is going to be removed from the list. The remove of the list is going to give me an error if I move on in the list in a normal way, due to the reorder of the list. What I can do is an iteration in an inverse way. I iterate from the last one until the first one. I make a sprites.getE. This way I can remove without an error. Here. This one can be replaced by 2. In the other way, it also works really. This return 2 in this event stops the evaluation of possible listener for this event. It is more efficient if you write 2 because it's not going to evaluate anything else. We want this one to be the only manager of this event. Here, we can ask him to make the method in sprite. Here, we should then return 2 if x2 and y2 is inside the area. How are we going to do this? In a short way, but a bit complicated. Okay, this way. Let's see if I can explain it. So that there is a collision, all these factors have to be 2. If any of these conditions is not 2, then the collision is going to be false. If the position x2, the click is going to be bigger than the x position of the sprite. This one here. If it's bigger, it means that it's on this side. If it's smaller, I mean, it fits smaller than the x position of the sprite plus the width of the sprite. It means that it's going to be on this side. With these two, and we are sure that it's on this side of the line. Click here or on top. Then, with these two question on x, we know that it is in this column here. The same column where the sprite is. We should do the same for y. If know that, for example, this one, here the y of the click is bigger than the y. This would be the point of the sprite. We know it's bigger and we know it's smaller than the y of the sprite plus the height. We know that it's in the row. It's as if it's here. If both conditions are true, we know that it's inside the character. We consider the sprite as a square. If we click on the square, it's going to be 2. Here it is. If it's bigger than x and smaller than x plus width, and if y2 is bigger than y, okay, let's try it. Here you can see it disappears. There is a small trick that makes this a bit ugly still. I clicked and they both disappear at the same time. Let's run it again. If you watch carefully and you click when both are together, I kill both. Here I have killed 3. For this game, this is not good. I want to kill only the one on top. To do this, to just kill the one on top, I should add a break. A break in the on touch. This for is going to iterate, and if there is more than one in the same position, it will work. This break is going to avoid this. Another detail which we have to take into account is going to be this synchronize. This onTouch event is going to be called in another different thread to the application. If you remember, we opened a thread, a game loop. It's the one which makes the update and the draw. We have this thread here, which will be the one of the application which is going to manage the events. This means that when we call here, it's going to be called in another thread to the one which is drawing. This can give us an error because of a synchronization problem. With this synchronize, we avoid that we have collisions between threads. We have collisions for the drawing. That's why I put get holder, because it's the container of the drawing. As you see here, in game loop, we have another synchronize for the same object. See, I have the view.getHolder. What does this mean? I can only execute this or this code in a synchronized way. We can't execute both at the same time. What is happening is that we can't mix the drawing with the modification of the data, which are going to be printed. For example, the remove is going to modify a sprite, which is going to be printed. The easiest way is this? It's a boy's disco to be run at the same time as this other code. With this. Okay, let's see. Here we have two together. Ouch. Here we have another problem. This event is executed very quickly a lot of times, so if I get out of the four, it goes into it again. It goes into it again also quickly, so, and it's in the same position. It is as if it tries with X and Y several times. The way to avoid this is to put a delay so that it doesn't execute in less than, instead of 500, I'm going to write 300 milliseconds. Okay, that should be okay. Let's close this. Let's create the field. Field, create field. That's it. With this, the first time we're going to see the time when it came in. And the second time we're only going to let him in if the difference between the present time and the last click is more than 300 milliseconds, less than a third part of a second. We are not going to notice, and we're going to get rid of that sensation. Okay, let's try it. Here it is. Let's look for two together. Here, I just killed one, and here I also killed just one. It works. Okay. This is all for this tutorial. See you in the next one.